有一名律师叫做 C.C. O'Leary， 他在 Heritage Foundation 的活动上面说，现在的 Title IX 的规定，学生或者是学校的员工可能触犯了条例，然后被开除。如果说他们造成的骚扰，例如他们口头上的骚扰、严重的持续性的骚扰，同时是客观的而且具有攻击性的骚扰的话，这边很重要，英文是 severe, pervasive and objectively offensive。 那拜登政府这边想要改变一个字，改成 severe, pervasive or objectively offensive， 就是严重的持续性的骚扰或者客观的具有攻击性的。那改了一个字是有很大的不同的，原本你要让学校开除一个人，你必须要说明这个人说话是很严重的，而且是有持续性的，而且同时是公认的充满仇恨的。光是这个样子就已经很严重的侵犯言论自由了，在大学里面，因为攻击性的言论基本上不可能是客观的，除非就是纯粹的脏话，例如 ，OK， 我不想说，你们自己想。但是现在拜登想要把 and 改成 or， 也就是或者是，也就是只要被认为是客观的仇恨言论，就可以把别人用 Title IX 来开除。我们来听一下他是怎么说的。
Severe, pervasive, and objectively offensive would be a man calling a woman a derogatory name. He says it, and we all agree that it's a bad name.He says it over and over again, and it causes her to maybe fear for her physical safety. Maybe he's shouting it at her as he's running after her. That would be harassment. Or maybe he's saying it over and over and over again in class to the point where she does not feel safe going to class anymore. That would be harassment under the current rule. Under the proposed change to the rule, it would just be saying a comment about, it would be misgendering somebody.It would be saying the wrong pronoun that person does not identify with. Under the new rule, that person could find that comment severe, period. And they could report you, and the college could find you guilty of harassment. So under this new proposed change to Title IX, we are worried that students are going to have their speech chilled even more than it already is. Students are going to be deterred from ever speaking up and sayinganything because they risk, especially conservative students, will risk their views being targeted and being punished now on their campus. So, you know, a concrete example of this could be you want to host a conservative speaker. Let's say you want to have Matt Walsh come onto campus and debate somebody. Under these new changes to Title IX, you might not be able to do that because Matt Walsh could be labeled a harassing figure and this is harassing speech.And therefore, the college will not allow him to come onto campus. So there are definitely some serious concerns here with this Title IX change. And
真的是很感谢这个女律师把这个东西指出来。但是这个就是左派未来的方向，或是拜登政府想要的方向。只要任何人说一句话是他们不喜欢的，就可以抓起来开除，夺取公民权。他们可以用这样子的手法，把任何人当成是人民公敌。任何不喜欢的评论都可以变成一个骚扰，任何骚扰都可以促成恐慌，任何促成恐慌的都可以是暴力跟仇恨犯罪，任何仇恨犯罪都必须要被抓起来。这所有的原因都是来自于我们对自己的自我错乱。当我们变成一个没有信仰、没有对错、任何事情都是主观的、没有客观的、没有事实的时候，我们每个人就会用我们的观点去来管理世界。我们的话语警察们就会使用他们的力量来禁止任何让人对于自己内心的经历产生疑问的话语。跟刚刚那个警察说的一样 ，speech that causes anxiety， 令人紧张的言论。因为如果你的言论就是你最真实的自己的话，那么反对你言论的就变成暴力攻击了，反对言论就变成在杀死你的方法了。这就是为什么。反对言论自由的人会不断的在寻找那些反对自己的言论，试图抹杀他们，但是却同时认为说自己是在为了言论自由而奋斗，因为对他们来说，他们心中的自我才是最真实的， 他们才是真正的言论自由。这些会杀死他们的言论，就是在杀死言论自由的时候，他们就会努力的、积极的摧毁所谓的言论自由，而且还以为他们是在保护言论自由，因为在他们的心中，他们对抗的不是言论，而是暴力，而是攻击。虽然不是实际上的攻击，但是是在攻击他们的内心，而对他们而言，他们的内心就是他们的一切。这就是当一个人内心空虚、脆弱、没有神，也不认识自己的时候会做的事情。为了自己扭曲事实、攻击自由、自以为意的摧毁整个时代的价值观跟所有的尝试。感谢大家收看，我是 Ethan， 更多美国情报请持续关注 AI News。